All right, Patrick, so because it's starting to come to the end of our five lesson series here, we got one lesson. What have you learned so far?
Well, I'm definitely turning through the ball now. I've got a good idea of my three-shot routine, and I'm picking a target line, so I'm a little more consistent, finding the ball consistently in the grass.
That sounds good. I like that. Yeah. How would you say your average scores have been since we started?
You know, I was up around like 73 when we started, and now I'm like, a bad day is 65.
That's what I like to hear.
You're doing a really good job.
Wow, thank you. That warms my heart as an instructor to hear my students doing so well. I mean, of course, you've probably made a little bit more money in your tournament series, which has got to make you happy.
Yep.
That'll help, you know, next time we have a lesson at the club for them. We get to get you in the putter.
Alrighty, well, let's see how this one works.
Yeah, you're going to need it, but that was a good putt because now you've made a par.
It went the right speed.
It did. That went the correct speed. You know what, Patrick? I'm going to have to say thank you for coming out. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Average score of 65.
Thank you, sir.
All right, Pat, so here we find ourselves with some very solid drives and a short par four. Now we have a short two-shot. So what I wanted to talk about is how our swing change from hip turn is going to transfer into this shot.
Okay.
I know we hit some wedges on the range, and you noticed that you were chunking them and pulling them left, which is probably good. Shot over water like this under pressure. So what I want you to step up and do is feel this is a 47-yard shot. I want you to feel like you're here and you still start everything through lower body instead of all upper body.
Okay.
Because that's just going to chunk it and put it in the water. These little nuggets are expensive, so we don't want to stop losing them, right? This will also help tournament scores go way down. Get up, take your stance, make sure you pick your target, turn those hips down.
Perfect.
Yeah, that was
right across the line.
So, let's see what you got. There you go, make sure you pick your target line. I might be asking you for lessons pretty soon. How about that?
That's awesome.
You might really go long. So now that we're out here on the course, Patrick, I want to try and get a little bit of what we worked on the range transfer over to on course play so we can strike the ball better. We're going to start off with a tee shot just to get you thinking about what we worked on the range so you can hit a good shot here. So do you remember what we talked about?
Kind of about picking our target line?
Yep. So when we pick our target line, that'll help us position the ball better for our second shot. And when you have an easier second shot, you have an easier third shot, and hopefully not even a fourth shot because you made a birdie.
Alrighty.
So what I want you to do is tee up the ball, and this is a slight dog leg left.
Okay.
Relatively open fairway, and the pin is in the front left portion of the green. So what is your best angle here to attack that pin?
Probably on the probably on the left side of the fairway, so I cut a little distance off.
You could cut a little distance off, but if on the left side of the fairway, there's a hazard that comes into play. We want to play away from that hazard.
Okay.
So left side of the fairway will cut some distance off the dog leg. Right side of the fairway is going to give you more distance. Let's go down the center so we kind of get a little bit of both worlds. You get some safe and you get to cut some distance off.
All right.
Take your target line and just remember to pull that hip through. There you go. It was a little push. You just didn't pull your hip through enough and you got a little cut. But I liked how you picked your target line there and did everything correct. Good job.
All right. Good shot.